that designates an ensemble of diverse actions that contain the production, distribution, exchange, and consumption of the photographic image. Each of these actions involved in the photographic event makes use of a direct or indirect power. Taking someone's portrait, for example, or looking at someone's portrait. End of quote. This is to remind you, or that we should be aware of, that we spectators who came to see this exhibition and who watched about 60 portraits shown here are part of the photographic event. The act of photography is always a joint action, a multi-participant action. As far as I could follow Roma textual and visual discourse, I came to understand that for some 30 years now, a number of contemporary Roma visual artists, historians, and theorists have been seriously engaged in bringing into being the Roma knowledges and deconstructing the century long tradition of constructing otherness of the Roma population via stereotyping them. Fitzowski claims that representation of gypsies in Poland have stubbornly maintained three views. First were a demonic view, which arose from the fear of the devil and sees gypsies as a tribe of sorcerers with supernatural powers arousing fear. Second view is a criminal view, treats gypsy society as a collective or organized professional criminal groups. And the third group is the operetta view, I love this title, holds that gypsies are romantic nomads living by music and love for nature. Are these views really passé? Hardly so. In the history of the portraiture, Puccia portraits could be recognized as occupational portraits. And this type of portraits the photographs were doing since the invention of photography. Let's see now whether Nino Puccia, with his occupational portraits of Roma artists, musicians, and performers, contribute to the subject I called Elephant and the Roma Question or not. Does his work shown here continue to manufacture the cultural cliché which have been historically formulated by both Roma and non-Roma photographers who could practice journalism or high art? These photographs, for me, subvert the cliché and stereotypes because they do not confront us with discomfort, drama, pathos, and victimization, even though the photographs emanate for me certain melancholy. In other words, these images of Roma are not threatening picture. In other words, the Roma question is presented here via the so-called positive images. This may trigger yet another question. Does exhibition, which I would call Who is Who in the Roma Art World, romanticize even elitist view of those Roma artists who made it in the field of high art? Indeed, Nino started to make these portraits in 2007, and the majority of them are taken in Berlin at or during the exhibition the artists had in the German capital, which seems to me the mecca for Roma artists. Looking at this series, can we really be sure that we are watching Roma individuals? In spite of the belief that the photographic image as visual evidence is enough, Nino believed this, he told me, Puccia has taken these pictures of the artist in front or in the vicinity of their works, and some of them with the tools they used at their work, like a photographic camera or a music instrument or a part of theater setting. But the pictures do not capture the artist while performing their profession, like painting or sculpting. There is no action in this photograph, but stillness, because stillness is required by the genre of portraiture. The artists shown here simply pose. They are staged by the photographer or self-staged. And this photograph, it's very important, are based on a mutual trust. The photographic contract is one between the partner participants in the act of the photography. The first hand is conceived as an ongoing photographic series. No single photograph, but only a series of photographs can show the photographer's intention. No single photograph is really decisive. The series constituting during the post-apparatus gesture or choosing single photograph. And because this work is conceived as a series, it can produce something that I think is very important in this exhibition. And this is certain awareness of belonging. This belonging is extraterritorial, since the artists who are photographed here are born or live in at least 18 countries in different nation states. This exhibition promotes a politics of friendship and counts on the affective and emotional links.